Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty McKean from Naio Nails. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do a fill. So we're going to basically fill the nails, rebalance them, ready for a brand new design. So you can see that Andrea has had these nails on for how long?
5 weeks, I think.
Yeah, about 5 weeks. So we have quite a bit of growth. She'd normally get about 4 weeks, but I might have slightly neglected.
Been on holiday.
Yeah, I've been on holiday. You've been on holiday as well, though.
Yeah. Yes, definitely.
Been busy, so couldn't really fit her in. So we're filming it. Just for you, so you can see exactly what I do. Did we not film these nails?
No, we didn't.
Oh, damn. Because they are very nice.
That's a really nice leaf. I've never seen you do that one before.
Yes, I know. It's quite cool to see that they, you know, they've lasted for so long. And the paintwork, you know, on that flat 3D has lasted as well. So I'm going to show you how to get this off as well. So you have to get the flower off, add the stones. I'm going to start with these stones. So these are some old cuticle nippers. And I can just get in a little bit easier with that because it's a smaller point. And I can start to crack the gel. So they are on with aqua gel. Mm-hmm. Look how that one just come off like that, dead easy.
Ping.
See, because you just need to crack the aqua gel and it'll just pop off. Get the rest of that off there. So I'm suggesting you're using old cuticle nippers because you don't want them to be really sharp. You want them to be quite blunt. They're just more just giving you like a leverage to get underneath and crack it away. You can do the same with your flat 3D, but because your flat 3D is really thin, you can just file over that with an electric file or even a hand file. Like if I show you with a hand file, you know, it does start to file off very easy, and that's only a 180 grit file. It's not, you know, a really coarse file. That will just file away. This one's slightly bigger, so we're going to give this a bit of a trim. Very important to support the nail. I'm really holding the nail really strong, and I'm supporting here, so if I'm pressing on this side, I'm supporting the nail on this side. So let's get rid of all this mess. Right, so we can see we've got quite a bit of growth. We are going to push back the cuticles. So I'm going to push back the cuticles, pushing them back dry. So I'm not adding any cuticle oil or cuticle remover or anything like that. And that's because I am going to fill them. I don't want to add any moisture to that natural nail. Water is one of the things that will penetrate through a natural nail. So if I put products on that have got water in or jojoba oil, then it will penetrate through the nail, and that's what I don't want. Because if there is moisture in the nail, it will create lifting, and we don't want that. And you can see that the nail has grown and it has slightly dropped. So it was further up before, but because the natural nail will grow and slightly slope, it will follow those contours. So we need to rectify that. So what I will do is, I will just take off a little bit of that side. And I'll rebalance it by bringing the apex into the back third again to rebalance the strength So first of all, I'm going to go over with my e-file and remove any bulk, taking off the top coat. You can see that sort of coming away. Don't forget to support the nail. And I'm just going to thin out this section here, which will make it easier when I come to file. Take off a little bit of that bulk there. You can do this with a hand file as well. This just makes the process a little bit quicker for me. No. What you don't want to do is touch the natural nail. You're going to try your best to sort of keep away from that natural nail. Have a look at this one. Oh, these nails just colour match me, eh, don't they? So again, I'm just thinning out that back area, and I'm moving all the time. I'm not holding this electric file on a certain point for too long, because you'll build up heat. So once you've done your electric filing, I'm going to obviously prep the back of the nail. So that fresh nail, we're going to remove the sign. We're going to remove the shine from the natural nail. So I'm going to support the nail and file those sides so they don't drop as much. What you want to be mindful of is that you don't interfere with the shape of the nail when you're doing this. We can do this because it's a ballerina shaped nail. If you were doing this on a stiletto nail, then you would end up taking the nail a little bit shorter, but that is something that some people do want when they've had, you know, nails on for 5 weeks. So let's have a look at this one. You can see how it drops a bit again. So again, I'm gonna take a bit of that side off. So you can see that's a lot straighter. You see the other side coming down lower. So we've taken off this side here. And we need to do the same on this side. Because if you look, you can see how it drops down. If we look at this side. Oh, come on, that's it, just break your finger. Can you see how much straighter it is? I mean, you can even see that other side sneaking down. But yeah, it's a lot straighter. So the nail will look a lot nicer. You do lose some of the C-curve. But it is worth it just to keep that nail a nice shape. But I only ever fill 3 times and then do a new set. The reason I only fill three times and do a new set is because I want to get that shape and that structure back into the nail.
Just about asked that. Did you preempt me there?
I think I preempted your question and stuff. I did. I think I just heard somebody going, but why? But for why did you do that? It's going to wipe over with pure acetone to clean it up, get rid of the dust. Now we're going to dehydrate. I do see people online put pictures of, look at these nails, they're still on and they've been on for 12 weeks. And I think, ooh, that's a lot of stress on the natural nail. Can you imagine how far down they grow and that stress on the natural nail? It's not good. Congrats for having great adhesion, but no, it shouldn't be on for that long.
No.
So this is the acid-based primer. I'm going to pop that on. Because I'm going to redesign these nails with gel polish, I do not need to fill them with the different colours because it really doesn't matter. I could fill them with clear if I wanted to. I don't need to get out the yellow and all the purples and all that. I don't need to do that. So I'm going to fill them with natural beige. And then in another video, you will see what I do. We'll do a before and after shot as well, so you can see the difference of how I've maintained the shape and brought it back to being a nice slim nail, because they start to look bulky as they grow out. So pop your bead on, make sure it's nice and neat at the cuticle. Make sure you go side to side. And then drag it down over. And this is the point that you need to check if you've got your apex. It's going to build up a tiny bit here. So I know I've got that apex in the right place. I'm gonna add a tiny amount just here. I feel like there's a bit of a dip. That'll cause a fracture point in the nail that'll be easily broken, and we don't want that. You can see that looks a lot better. Tipping the finger down so it's not going to touch the cuticle. Go side to side. Pull down. Tiny bead there, make sure I've got that apex.
How do you know when you've got a good bead?
Well, I put that bead away then because it wasn't big enough. But a good bead is a bead that sort of holds its shape a little bit and doesn't run away too quickly. So when you put it onto the nail, if it sort of wants to run straight away, it's far too wet. If you can't move it around, then it's too dry.
And it's just experience that enables you to figure that out while it's actually still on the brush.
Yes. It's the 20 plus years of experience that I have that makes me be able to just know. Right, so we've picked this bead up now. So I know I'm going in, I'm dragging off, and I'm going in with the wet side. I'm going in low. I've tapped a couple of times. Perfect. It's polymerizing. It's not moving anywhere. I can still move it around. I can press it into place. And that's your perfect bead. So it'll kind of look like wet sugar when it's on the brush. If it looks like a shiny, shiny pearl, then it's definitely too wet. So like if I go like this, shiny straight away, too wet. Wet sugar. You see how it's textured? And then it starts to shine because it's polymerizing. The thing is though, sometimes you want a wet bead, sometimes you want it drier. So it all depends what you're using the bead for. If you're creating just structure, then you need that sort of medium ratio. A bead that lets you move it around, but will not run away. Kind of like a man.
You can move it around and it won't run away.
Yeah. Can boss it about,
yeah,
but it won't run away.
Won't run away.
Yeah. A happy medium. Yeah. I've not found that yet.
No,
he'll run away. I'm only joking.
You know what, laughing at I that gets left in. I bet he had me bloody marriage proposals, yeah.
Oh no, it's Adam that gets the marriage proposal stuck. Oh, we're set. We are set. So, sidewalls, nice and straight. Let's get that cuticle nice and neat. Contour the top surface. Bringing everything back into shape. So I'll show you a bit closer on this one. So the sidewall's nice and straight, yeah? And get that cuticle nice and neat. So you can see we've got the apex in the back third here, and it goes nice and flat here, so it's straight. We've removed the apex from here and moved it back to where it should be in the back third of the nail. If we hadn't removed the bulk from here, then we would be left with quite a chunky nail that would sort of resemble a tortoiseshell shell. You know, like a big hump. But no, we don't want that. We wanted to move the apex from here to the back third. So we have a lot of maintenance on that and rebalance the whole structure of that nail. So I'm just going to make sure this curve's nice underneath here and just use a thin bit and just go in and take any bulk from the underside and create a nicer curve. And then what I'm going to also do is I'm going at the back here and I'm cleaning out any bits and bobs that shouldn't be there. No, really, what we're doing is smoothing out this nail. So you can see the natural nail. A lot of people don't like seeing the natural nail here. So we are just buzzing that thin and flat. A lot of people don't like the fact that their natural nail, that it comes away from the acrylic. If it's not hydrated, then it will come away from the acrylic. But what we're doing now is getting rid of that natural nail that's popping through that growth. It won't then come away from the acrylic because it won't be there. And it'll also look a lot neater underneath the nail. I'm going to buff over now to remove those demarcations. So all those little scratches, we're just going to soften those now and smooth out the nail. I'm going to wipe over with pure acetone. And I'm going to take that and clean underneath. Because what that'll do is it'll melt that tip. These are tips, aren't they?
Yeah.
So it'll melt the tip and it'll make it look a lot cleaner and neater. I am just going to put some cuticle oil on now just to replenish that moisture. We are going to do a design on these in the next video. So you can have a little look at that. But have a little look at the before and after. And have a look at the difference of how, you know, ignore the design, but look at the shape. We've got that shape nice and neat. We've rebalanced everything. You know, people think there isn't much involved in having a fill done, but there is a lot of work and thought that goes into it. So yeah, guys, I hope you've enjoyed that video. I hope it helps you when you come to either fill your own nails or fill your client's nails, whatever you're doing. And all the products that I have, all the products that I've used today will be listed below. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye. I've even got a bit of rust on my hand off these nippers, which is lovely, bit of rust there, lovely. Can't you tell they're old? I love it when that happens and it just goes, comes off like that.